One of the big challenges facing electric vehicles, as I'm sure you'll know if you're an electric car driver, is the time it takes to refuel your car on a long distance trip. But don't get me wrong, in the past decade, we've seen dramatic improvements in this, thanks to improved rapid charging infrastructure, improved rapid charging speeds, and larger capacity battery packs, all of which make it easier than ever before to drive long distance by electric car. Yet, still the critics come, moaning that until they can refuel their cars in 10 minutes or less, they're not interested in a plug-in car. And so we've started to see some really high-powered charging systems being developed by both automakers and charging providers in an attempt to get the charge time down for electric cars while simultaneously accommodating ever larger capacity battery packs. Except there's a problem with this. The more power you need to transfer, the larger the connector becomes that you need to transfer that power, or the more you need to focus on cooling in order to ensure that the large currents can be transferred from charging station to car without causing major issues to the battery pack. Because without doing so, you create a massive amount of heat, which can ultimately lead to battery pack premature aging and failure. Which is why Tesla has been working on a new type of charging station that charges your car and cools the battery at the same time. Intrigued? I'll explain more next. Stay where you are. Hi there, I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield from Transport Evolved, and today we're going to be looking at the recently released patent application made by Tesla to the US Patents and Trademark Office for a new type of supercharging system that's designed to help keep electric car battery packs cool while charging them at seemingly impossible high charge rates. As our friends at Electrek reported over the weekend, Tesla first applied to patent the battery cooling while charging technology back in 2014, updating the application in 2016 before it was finally published earlier this month. Titled Charging Station Providing Thermal Conditioning of Electric Vehicle During Charging Session, the patent lays out a couple of different options Tesla is presumably investigating as a way of keeping its electric car battery packs cool while charging them at very high power rates. But before I get too much into the patent itself, I guess it makes sense just to go over why cooling might be needed in the first place. You see, most lithium-ion electric car battery packs are a little like us. They prefer temperate conditions that are not too hot and not too cold. Push them too hard in the middle of winter and their range will suffer as internal cell resistance goes up in the cold weather and the battery wastes more of its energy and heat. Push them too hard in hot weather and the battery will suffer premature battery aging. Which is why most modern electric cars, the Nissan Leaf and Mitsubishi i-MiEV are exceptions, use active thermal management systems designed to keep the batteries at a comfortable room temperature at all times. So far, so good. But when you charge a battery, especially at high currents, the battery itself will heat up. That's because when you push high currents through a metal conductor, more of the power passing through it is lost to heat. Think of it a little like trying to walk through a corridor with a group of people versus trying to run through the same corridor with the same amount of people. More people will bump into one another and you'll all get hotter to boot. My terrible physics analogy out of the way, there are two ways to fix this problem. First, you make the conductor, the corridor, bigger, which makes it easier for larger currents to pass through, or you cool the conductor down as a way of offsetting the heat generated by the current passing through the conductor. Obviously, you can only go so big with connectors, so the preferred option right now is to cool down the cables and the connectors, and that's where Tesla's patent comes in. In its patent, and remember that this isn't a definite production plan, but rather an engineering possibility, Tesla describes a series of different computer-controlled cooling mechanisms that it could use to provide additional high-capacity cooling whilst charging an electric car. They all revolve around an undercar solution that either pumps coolant around a heat exchanger mounted under the car, thus assisting the car's onboard battery cooling system, or using some form of air-based cooling system that could force air in between the battery cells in the battery pack in order to keep them cool as the car charges at rates in excess of several hundred kilowatts. Current cooling technologies are based entirely on car, and for now, can cope with the level of thermal management required during high current supercharging. But as supercharging and other DC quick charge systems push well beyond 2, 3, or maybe even 400 kilowatts, which would fill a Tesla 100D battery pack to 80% in about a quarter of an hour, external cooling would make it far easier for automakers to keep battery packs cool without requiring massive, oversized onboard charging systems. Tesla's patent application does seem to cover all of the bases with a variety of different solutions, and which it would, anyone else would make it difficult for other automakers to follow suit. But in Tesla's case, at least, given its past treatment of patents as something to share quid pro quo, I think it could lead to a future where any battery-developed cooling technology could be shared. This technology is likely also preferable to battery swap technology for customers too, as customers will know exactly what the history of their car's battery pack is, rather than taking on board an unknown battery when their car's battery pack is depleted. From a technical standpoint too, this system would be a lot cheaper to implement, as it would not require an on-site battery storage system. And while I'm on the topic of battery swapping and cooling, I should note here that this isn't the first time we've seen active cooling tried as a way of keeping battery packs healthy during rapid charging. Better Place, the now defunct Israeli company which tried to bring battery swapping for electric cars to the world, actually charged the Renault Fluence ZE battery packs used in its battery swap stations at 50 kilowatts or so while they were off the car, the same speed as they would be charged in, say, a Nissan Leaf, but did so whilst forcing cooled air through the battery pack inside the swap station so the battery packs were kept at an ideal temperature. As I've pointed out, there's no confirmation that Tesla will be using the technology referenced in its patent in its future production vehicles. And companies, especially ones on the cutting edge of a new technology, patent stuff all the time without actually ever using it. But I'm eager to know what you think about the various different possibilities for external battery pack cooling while charging, what the challenges might be, and how effective you think it would be in the real world. Leave your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell your friends and family about this show. And if you liked what you saw today, please do consider helping me to make more shows like this by making a monthly donation through Patreon. There's a link below in the description, and there's also a clickable one at the end of today's video. I'll be back tomorrow, but until then, thanks for joining me. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield, and as always, don't forget to keep evolving.